Pride Month may have already come and gone, but Winnipeg Pride's 2021 virtual Pride celebrations are just around the corner. President and Chair of Pride Winnipeg, Barry Karlanzig, joins me now to talk about what people can expect from the upcoming festivities. Thank you so much for taking the time to chat with me today, Barry.
No problem.
Can you tell me a little bit about what celebrations Pride Winnipeg has coming up?
So Pride Winnipeg has actually a week-long worth of celebrations. We'll be starting with our flag raising, whether it's virtual or in-person, again, depending on the current vaccine rollout, on September 3rd at City Hall, followed by 10 days of events. So instead of last year where we did just a weekend festival, we're actually doing programming throughout all 10 days of Pride. And that'll be a wide variety of performances, or drag performances, songs, DJs, panel series, and then working with our community partners at the same time to ensure that none of our events coincide with the same time that one of their events is going.
Is there a reason that it's being held in September as opposed to June?
So the reason originally was there was a twofold approach when we did it back in March to make the decision to move it into September was with the hopefulness that the vaccine rollout would have rolled out, which would allow us to do something in person, whether it be small or large, but also with a lot of our recording venues that we were using, there was a large amount of individuals that had had their weddings or funerals postponed or celebrations of life postponed where they were taking those areas. And we didn't want to interfere with that. So we said, you know what, let's move to September so that we can keep those venues free for anybody who wants to do celebration of life, weddings, divorce parties, as we've seen, things like that, whatever needed to be there.
Other than the flag raising that you've already mentioned, is most of this going to be pre-recorded virtual stuff that people can tune in, or
yeah,
is that still up in the air?
It'll all be pre-recorded. So all of the performers have already been pre-recorded and our production teams are slowly merging them together, adding ASL, that type of stuff. We are going to be doing a virtual parade this year. So there will be Sunday morning, there will be a virtual parade. We're working on the final logistics. And then we are still planning to have the Pride Vigil, which is always the Sunday of Pride weekend. The goal is to still have that at the Manitoba Legislative Grounds in person. But again, depending on social distancing guidelines and rules and variant to the different variances that we see, that may change.
Why is it important to have events like these, even if it is a recorded virtual event?
I think it's always important. Pride month is more than just a month. It's 365 days a year. And as much as Pride Winnipeg normally kicks off Pride season, by doing it, we're bringing more focus to a part of the community that still doesn't have equal representation. So looking at the acronym, you look at the L and the G, a lot, the L and the G has fairly good representation since the 80s and since the Pride movement, but the other letters of the alphabet still don't have those equal rights. So by doing this and still having our pride parade or our pride march and the festival ensures to bring focus to those socially excluded groups so that one day they do have equal rights so that the next generation doesn't go through the same issues we did when we were first coming out, or I did when I came out 12 years ago.
Obviously things are changing week to week. How can people stay up to date with what you guys are doing and get involved?
So stay up to date, follow us on our Facebook, PrideWinnipeg.com, our Instagram, and we actually will be relaunching our Pride app this year. Follow our Pride app, our Pride website, our social media, and you'll be able to stay tuned. The other thing we are going to be doing this year for Pride season, similar to what we did in June, you will see a bunch of contests that are going to be launched. We will be launching contests both on our app and on our website, and every day that you tune in, you'll get an extra, they'll be at the top of the screen every day, there'll be a little access code that you can get for more draws into the ballot. So then you'll see every day different prizes and things like that going on. And we're going to be working with all of our community partners on that. And an extra feature we're going to do this year is for most of the performances, after all the performances are done during Pride Week, we're going to be able to keep them on our YouTube account for a period of 30 days. So keep them until the end of September. The goal is to ensure that those who might not be able to tune in on that day still have the ability to watch that. And also those who might not be able to watch at all because of they might not have access to a computer or their phone or YouTube, etc. It'll allow them to be able to visit with their friends or something later on and be able to watch something to still partake even after the fact.